Hello, it's me, Franz. Anyways, so I have not taken a closer look at this piece of shit website, and there's a lot of stuff wrong with this thing. I think this was either made by a 12-year-old or by a girl, a female. This was for sure not made by a professional. It was some idiot. Maybe it was some nerd, who knows? But I'll show you what's wrong with it and where you can make improvements, because it's just bad in any sense. So first, I think this is the more critical stuff. Now, the problem with the website is that you don't have to have any money on it. You cannot even put any money on it. So let's say we would want to play with this girl, random girl here. And we would want to play with her, then we just click on chat. And if the page doesn't break, then we could now chat, right? And then we'd be like, "Hello, you want play game?" And then eventually they answer, or they don't answer most of the time. But the biggest problem here is that even if I just made this account a second ago, I could still do this. I could still just message people. And now imagine you're a weirdo, where you just make an account with a VPN and an incognito window. Probably don't need any of this anyways. You go here, you chat them, you're like, "Yeah, what's up, dude?" And then if they reply, you just send them a dick pic. Because if you click on this thing, you can literally just send them a dick pic straight away. It does not matter. You can send them how someone's head is getting chopped off, whatever, right? There is no secure. See? She's like, "Hello, sorry, but today's unfortunately my day off." Whatever, right? And then now I send her a dick pic and she would be like, "Oh shit!" You know what I mean? So, anyways, I think it's very stupid. Now, it's just dangerous, right? I mean, I don't know if you want to consider that dangerous, but if you want to protect the people that are working for you in one way or another, then you know. Restricting this is, well, should be at least the standard, but it's not. The next thing is the matchmaking, or there's no matchmaking. So if you wanted to play a game, you choose a game from here, right? And then you try to find someone who plays the game. And for Counter-Strike, there's quite a lot of people. You click here on more, and then you click on online or whatever. And then you filter them. You can see them here, right? You can click on price and what server they're playing on. And basically, the only thing you do is you go price if you want to go whatever, you know, and then maybe your rank so you can find someone in your range. Now, the problem with this, that's it. Is there's only one girl? See, tell you, piece of shit said. The problem is that it shows you all these people. Now this is let's see, if we go with $1 to $5, there's a lot of people here, lots of people, lots of people, and these are all online right now apparently, right? It says online only. Now if you click on one and then you start to chat, because you don't just buy something if you don't even know that they're here, and then you're like, "Hello, do you want to play the game?" and shit like that. The problem is that I would say 80% of them are not even here. So you send them a message and then you never get a response. Not in like some of them haven't responded at all, like 24 hours after I first tested this. And if you want to have like a good like a customer experience, the most important thing is that you make it easy for the customer. You know, I as a customer, if I want to buy a CSGO account, what I want to do is I go to the website, I click on what I want, and then I get the first account that is in those parameters, right? If I want to buy a Master Guardian account, then I don't choose the account, you know? It's not like I choose the account name, the account password. I don't choose any of this. I just buy a Master Guardian account and they send it to me. It takes me 2 minutes from registering to actually having the account. It takes 2 minutes because it's that simple. But here it takes you 2 hours to find one person to play with. Unless you already have found some the previous day and shit like that. So I think the smartest idea would actually be to make like a matchmaking system for this game, you know, for this website. So if you have like a button like this one here, the become an e-girl, but actually have a button here, start now or something. Now you click on that button and then it shows you like, you know, what game do you want to play? Then you pick that game, pick your price range or something like, you know, below this price. For example, you only want to spend a maximum of $2. And then it gives you the first person that is currently here. Now here comes the cool thing. On the other side, on the people that are working here, what they have to do is they also click a button, maybe this button, for example, they click on it and then they become active. So I don't know, every 10 minutes, for example, they have to click the button that they are actually here, that they are waiting for a customer. So if I come on this website, I click on this button, then I get connected to, I don't know, the first girl that is waiting the longest or some shit like that. And then I get their profile, like this one, for example, when we basically matchmaked, then I get the profile, I can listen to her voice, be like, okay, I want to play with that one or not. And if I don't want to play with that one, I just reroll or I click on something like ignore or bullshit, I don't know. And so I can go through the actual active people and play with them, you know? Instead of having to go to all of those AFK idiots and then, you know, like the one we just say here, she's online, but she's like, hello, sorry, but today's unfortunately my day off. Why the fuck are you online then, you fucking idiot? Go offline, you piece of shit, if you don't want to work. How is that logic, you know? I mean, I don't show up in my supermarket wearing my supermarket t-shirt and going through the shelves and putting shit in there when somebody comes over to me and is like, yo, where can I find the milk? Dude, I'm not working today! Leave me the fuck alone! It's not happening, you know? I don't even go near that supermarket. I don't work in a supermarket, but that was just an example. So TLDR, this website is absolutely stupidly made in any aspect. And I think maybe there should be another website. They could probably just get egirl.com, but again, I guess if I go to that website, it's probably a porn site. But let me check. Egirl.com. Okay, it's already taken. My story is not very different from other girls my age. I guess my... whatever. It's not a porn site. You can look it up. So TLDR, this whole thing needs a revamp. Literally everything. And maybe the next thing, the very first thing they should add is make it so that you put money on the website and then use that as your payment gateway. You know, like you put like $3 on there and then you buy a girl and you can only talk to the girls if you actually have money. Because right now, as I said, I can just talk to the first girl. It doesn't even know if I have money because buying something is super easy. You know, you just click here, you click here, and then you click here, and then you go to PayPal, and that's GG, you know, you pay. The next thing which I just see here is, why do I have to pay the transaction fee? That's not how that works. If the price is $1, then that's $1. This is the scamming, you know? Like, if I go to a restaurant, and the cheeseburger is $2, then the tax is already in there, you know? Then, I don't know, whatever tax rate your country has, they put the $20, the 20% already on that, so it's $2 or $1.99 or whatever you're paying for your cheeseburger. I don't pay the price. It's always like that. If you buy something on eBay or on Amazon or anywhere, then the seller pays the transaction fee or whatever. I don't even know if these girls actually get the full $1 or whatever they charge. Like if the girl charges $1, I wonder if they get the full $1 or if they also have to give a cut to the website. Either way, I don't give a shit. Even if this one, the 0.33 cents here, dollars, if that is actually what goes to the website. Who knows? I don't know. I don't give a shit. I'm not supposed to pay that. I pay $1 if it's $1. Simple as that. I don't pay a transaction fee. It's stupid. It's stupid. It's stupid for me and it's stupid for everyone else. That's not how that works. It's a scam. You pay the transaction fee because you want the money. I would be cool if we just played the game, you know? Anyways, this website is retarded. Everyone on the website is probably retarded because, well, not the people working here, but the people in the administration. They're all stupid. They must be stupid. Sorry to tell you, but that's how it is. It's a horrible website. I don't even want to know how many exploits this website has. Like, underlying exploits. Look, I got a message. Look at that. That was yesterday at 4 in the morning. And now, 22 hours later, she replies. Wow, that was fucking fast. Let's play a game, dude. Jesus.